guys. Good day. I know you guys missed me anyways because I've been seeing your comments. Sorry, I actually missed yesterday's live stream. Welcome guys to today's video, and we are going to be talking about short courses that you can actually do in aviation. Short, not so simple, a little bit complicated. Some of them are a little bit complicated, but they are short courses that you can actually do and work in the aviation industry as a professional too. So because I've been seeing in some of the comments of my videos and also on Instagram, people have been asking me this question, maybe due to the way the season is this period. So people are trying to wonder, okay, what can they do at this time? So I practically understand, and I decided I'm going to meet this need by telling you some short courses that you can actually venture into immediately the whole lockdown and pandemic or whatever, it's over. So guys, welcome. Hi, Anu-PrincessAnuTv, welcome on board. Thanks so much for joining me. Basically guys, if you're new here, this is NCAT. We talk about aviation, motivation and adventure. And if you've not subscribed, I'm going to be giving you a minute, like a minute. Anyways, just click on the subscribe button. Sorry, click on the subscribe button and the bell so that you do not miss anything on this channel. Like, you really need it, trust me, you need it. So guys, I'll be going straight into the topic, even as we wait for other people to like join us. I hope you guys can see me and hear me clearly. Anyways, okay, I hope so. And so if you can see me and hear me, the first course that is a short course that you can do in aviation is the cabin crew course. I know why I'm basically starting from the cabin crew course. Let me reposition this. I trust you guys can see me now clearly. Okay, so the cabin crew course is a course that you can do. It's basically 3 months in some schools. Thank you so much, Aminu. I'm happy you can hear me. Nat Bruce, Satali, welcome guys. Victory Matthew, first time I'm seeing this name. Welcome, seems like a new subscriber. Don't forget guys, give this video a thumbs up. It's very, very important. Yeah, we are, don't worry, we're almost at 2,000 subscribers. Thank you so much for the encouragement. Yes, we are growing all together. Guys, don't forget, give this video a thumbs up. Sadis Muhammad, welcome on board. Nice having you. You guys are just the best. Maternity Tally, a shout out especially to you on your birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Anyways, you're going to be telling us your age. Ike Chukwunoha, welcome. No, I'm not a new sub. Oh, sorry then. Sorry, that means you've not been joining our live streams because I don't think I've seen. Oh, now I can remember that name. Okay, guys, let's not get too distracted. Karut, welcome, guys. You guys are the best. Oh, you say you're 16 now. I hear you. Anyways, let's continue. I was talking about the cabin crew course. You can do it. Is a 3 months course. Another course is the flight dispatch course. That course you can do it for practically 6 months. So NCAT does it. Their timing is actually 6 months. Maya, welcome. I'm fine. Their time is actually 6 months, but like the cabin crew course can be shorter. Some places actually do shorter, but just be sure that wherever you're going to for the cabin crew course, you're getting your value for your money. Trust me, some places they actually rush it and they don't give you the whole thing. But some places, like, they take their time, but they give you the whole pack, the real pack. So, and thanks for all you do. I started my flight training in South Africa. Wow, I'm happy for you. How is it going already for you? How is it going, especially at this time? Because I talked to one of my friends yesterday, and she told me that they are already flying in the US. So, they are back to their flying schedule and all that. So, I think a lot of persons are already flying, and I'm hoping and trusting God that we are going to be called back soon. In fact, I'm praying about it. They're going to be called back soon too to fly so that we can just, you know, wrap up the whole thing. So, another course, guys, the marshalling course. Sincerely, I don't know how long the marshalling course takes, but I know it's definitely not going to take so much because it's marshalling, obviously, with the name. Not that marshalling is so little, but it doesn't require so much technicalities. So you can also do the martial arts. There are people that are professional marshallers. You have them in the military, you have them in the civil. Their work is to marshal you, the aircraft, the pilots, park here, park there, and all that. We are going back to flying now. Wow, this is good news. I'm happy to hear that. I'm happy. I hope to share my own good news. Like, I'm happy for you, seriously. Like, a lot of persons actually have started going back to flying. And Sahi, welcome. We started going back to flying. I think it's a good thing. It's a very, very good thing. Don't forget, guys, give this video a thumbs up. It's very, very important. And if you have any questions, you can ask before we are done with the video. Then also, ticketing and reservation is also a short course that you can do. Guys, in case you're just coming in, I've talked about the cabin crew course, 3 months. I've talked about the flights, dispatch course, which you can basically have for 6 months. Maybe some places can do it less, I don't know, but I know that NCAT like does their own for 6 months. Then I've talked about the marshalling course. I really don't know how long it takes, but I know it doesn't take long. The marshalling course, you can check that out. Then now I'm talking about the ticket and reservation. That is another course. In fact, I was surprised when I checked online and I discovered that there are actually schools. In fact, there's one I saw I think late this evening that is actually doing that course, ticket and reservation, because you know you have a lot of tourists flying, doing a lot of things. And so these are courses that if you're thinking, what can I do in aviation? Okay, maybe I don't have the money, but you just want to be around the aviation industry, because there's something. Seems like I'm talking so fast. Anyways, there's something that I got to discover. Today I got an email from Gulf Aviation Academy for cabin crew. Guys, I love hearing good news. This feels good. Like coming on board, discussing with you guys, and you guys is like sharing your testimonies. I'm so happy. And I really want to say this before we jump into other things. Please, maximize every opportunity you're getting. Seriously. But they are saying no job guarantee, you have to search for jobs. The main thing is, even if they are saying no job guarantee, so far you're sure that they're going to train you well. Another thing is the training free? Are they doing like something like a cadet program? Well, if it was a cadet program, definitely you have a job. So I'm sure that maybe they're just like telling you can come for the training. But it's a step. When you get there, you get to see other aviation professionals and all that, and you get contacts. So even if they're telling you no job for now, there's no place that actually guarantees you job except you are actually under a cadet program, because I think the cadet program is the fastest way to actually get a job, because these guys are saying, I'm going to train you and I'm going to give you the money, I'm going to give you the job, so you come and fly for me. So I'm basically paying for you to train and you're coming to repay me back by flying for me. But apart from that, every other place you go to learn the cabin crew, piloting and all that, sincerely, there's no guaranteed job in quotes if you're not in a cadet program, if you are not sent by military or something. It has to be around this area. So I'm really happy for you, first of all, and I'm so happy when you guys share good news like this. Like, I feel good, you know, because good news, like good things are happening to you, definitely it's going to be happening to others on the channel, and it's going to be happening to me also, and that's why I feel good about it. So please take hold of the opportunity. Is cadet very good? It's good because you're sure of a job. The only thing is that as you keep advancing in your career, you get to discover that sorry guys, I'm digressing from the topic. I really need to talk on these things that you guys are asking, because they are very important. And in case you're new here and you don't know, we talk about random things on the channel and on the live stream, so you can join us by 5 p.m. in case you're watching this video when it's already uploaded. So cadet program, like I was saying, when you keep advancing in your career, you get to discover that you want more, you want better, you understand. It's just like a company is keeping you on a cadet program and they say you have to fly for us for 10 years or you have to fly for us for 5 years because they were the ones that paid for your tuition. And you got to discover that even after flying for them for like 2-3 years, you have more than enough money to even pay them back, but because you've signed a bond with them, you have to stay with them. Or maybe you've gotten so much experience that you want to move over to another airline, but you can't move over because you've signed a bond with them. But the good thing about it is that they paid for your training and you have a guaranteed job. Don't forget, if you don't have a guaranteed job, you don't have what it takes to actually move to the other airlines that you want to move to, because it's an experience, it's experience and hours that makes you move to the other airlines. So I think cadet program is a good thing. If you see a cadet program, I think you should venture into it. But if you have the money to actually train yourself, then you can do well to train yourself and maybe forget about the cadet program, then maybe later you find a job by yourself. So it depends on you and it depends on your choices, seriously. Okay, I mean, which airline do you want to work with in Nigeria? For now, I don't have any specific airline that I have. And will I say I don't have any specific airline, but I can't really say for now. It all depends. Like I said, as student pilots, we don't like choose. For now, we only take hold of opportunities that come to meet us. And that's what I'm planning to do. Take hold of any opportunity that comes to meet me or that I go to search out for. So let's leave that plane for now. Thank you for asking. Okay, Sahi, they are saying, will your parents pay 1 cent or 60 to 70 lekas? Okay, you're talking India. I think this is India, yeah. Okay, for CPL, and they are saying my height is very less for becoming a pilot. 158 centimeters is very less, they say. Like I said before, guys, on the Shegu, you're super late. Obviously, we've gone so far in the discussion. Like I said before, you see, the issue about pilot height and weight, or pilot height and all the other things that are attached to it, is that every parastatal has their own specifics. Some parastatals will say we want pilots for at least 160 centimeters. Some are going to say 153, 152, it's okay with us. Some are going to say we don't even want pilots that are too tall. It all depends on the organization you're going to work for. But I always advise, before you rule out yourself, do well to go to the flight school that you intend to attend and ask them, do they have a specific height requirement, weight requirements, eye requirement, all those requirements? Ask them specifically. Then when you get to find out, you will now know, okay, maybe they don't accept, maybe they're not going to accept me. If you're going for a cadet program, in the course of the cadet program, in fact, before they even give you the sponsorship and everything, they're going to tell you that we want persons of so height, we want persons of so weight. If you're fat like this, we might not accept you. If you're so tall, we might not accept you. If you're so short, we might not accept you. But it all depends on their own requirements. So if they say 158 is too short for them, then you have to consider somewhere else. Obo Wisdom, welcome. FNG Tampico, you're late. You guys are late, like super late. Anyway, so these are some things you should actually consider. If that one is not working for you, I would advise that you go look for another. That one will likely work. Trust me, it's going to work. So where did I stop? I was talking about some courses you can do. I think I stopped at the flight dispatch course. Then I have some other courses here. The postgraduate diploma, you can also do. Muhammad Farouk, welcome. Yeah, you're late. You can also do the postgraduate diploma. The postgraduate diploma is not that short. I think 1 year is actually long. Jethro Yusuf, welcome. 1 year is long. That's not short, but it's fair because it's a management, it's an aviation management program that you can actually work your way around. Then which other one do I have here? AFSEC program. And yeah, I was talking about the basic ticketing and reservation. That one is about roughly 2 weeks, 10 days. Yeah, around 10 days to 14 days. So it all depends on the flight aviation school you want to attend. So that will determine how long you're going to spend, but it's not long. 2 weeks is a short time. It's a course that you can do if you want to. You know, the best thing is always to stay within the aviation industry. Don't go so far out of the aviation industry. If you say you want to really stay in aviation, probably you don't have the money yet. It's always good to be hanging around the aviation industry. Don't go to something entirely different. If you go to something entirely different, it will be hard, or it might be hard for you to actually come back. So I think you should put that, you should take note of these things. If you don't have the money now, guys, if you don't have the money now to do this aviation courses I'm talking about, to do the flying, the aircraft maintenance engineering, that are quite expensive, or which other one, air traffic control, they are quite expensive, you can go for these other short courses I'm mentioning so that you remain around the confines of the aviation industry. Then when you have the money, because the truth is that when you remain around the area, you're going to meet people, you're going to like hear information, so you're going to hear about scholarships, sponsorships and all that, and before you know, you're inside the aviation industry. But if you go so far out, I'm sorry, it might be difficult for you to come. So guys, these are the few courses I have for you. Other ones I have here are actually courses that you do on top the other courses. Just like for you to do a CFI, that's a Certified Flight Instructor rating, you need to actually have had your CPL, your PPL, all those things, you need to have had them. And so I'm not going to say it's a short course because it also requires a lot of money. But these other ones I mentioned, they are not so expensive. You can do them and you'll be fine. Anthony, welcome. Welcome. Nice seeing you here. Okay, over wisdom, why is it that when airplanes are flying in the sky, there's always a white line? It's actually called vortices. Like, don't worry, we're going to talk. Okay, maybe we should do, I've been wanting to actually do a tutorial, but I don't know how it's going to be for you guys yet. So we can like do a tutorial together, like we can learn together, we discuss aerodynamics together, we discuss metrology together, we discuss human performance together. Like, it just depends. It just depends. So if you guys want the tutorials, let me know in the comment section, please, because it's your feedback that's actually going to determine if we're going to do that. So we can talk on aerodynamics once in a while. We can talk on metrology. I actually like metrology. We can talk on human performance for now, because I think these are notes I actually brought back home. So if you want it, let me see your comments after this video is uploaded. Please put your comments in the comment section so that I count and know how many persons that want it, so that I know if it's actually worth it to do it. Hi Abayomi, welcome aboard. You are super late. We are already done. We're talking about the short courses that you can do in aviation, so I think you can replay back the video to watch. Okay, Ikechukwu Onoha, which schools offer PGD? Can you go for PGD after flight school without going to a uni? You can actually go for PGD. It's actually, if you have your flight school certificate, I think you can do a PGD. Yes. If you've also done any other course relating to aviation or something, you can do PGD. NCAT actually offers PGD. It's there, and it's actually for 1 year. 1 year, depending on the actual course you want to do, it's actually for 1 year. Then you have some other minor courses in the PGD that maybe all this first aid stuff and all that. So you just have those ones anyways. So it depends. It depends on what you want to do. So guys, I hope you were touched. I hope you were blessed. How is it? I hope you're blessed. I think I'm in a church. Anyways, this is my congregation. You guys are the best. And so I'm going to be seeing you guys tomorrow. Don't come late tomorrow. Please, please. So that you don't miss out on the information. You don't miss out on the discussions that we are having. You know, it helps for us not to go back and repeat a lot of things that we've talked about. So if you want, like I said, yes, you're leaving them in the live stream, but also leave them in the comment section of this video when it's uploaded, so that I can count. I'll do a roll call and know if you guys want the tutorial, so that we can start the tutorial by God's grace maybe next week or so that I can plan very, very well for it. So I will see you guys tomorrow. You guys are the best. Like, you guys touch my heart so much. And don't forget to watch my latest video, 15 things I wish I knew. Carrie Roots, you're the best. You're never late. Like, never late. Never late. So, guys, to meet again. Bye.